Getting up in the dark as heck. It's really a pain in the neck. We were quite a sight, gathering in the night, waiting for the radio check.
Dropping down now to a Hampton station. We won't stay here. I don't believe we just circle around. But the inscription on the marker down here is also in your book. So you can read those, that and the one up on the road that we passed talking about Hensley's Crossing.
By the Mormons at their fort on the Malab River in Salt Lake Valley and was not allowed to go into the settlements, but was sent back. That while he was at the Malab fort, he purchased two oxen from a Mormon named John Barnard that said that the said Barnard told him that he had bought these cattle from the Digger Indians who live about the settlements and who range as far as the Humboldt River, and that these Indians had stolen them from the immigrants on the road to California.
We went up the Montana Trail, up many a hill and a dale, up to Eagle Rock, and there we did gawk at the falls while some drank their ale. Taylor built a bridge with a toll. He charged before wagons could roll. Some he charged dollars over their haulers as they continued on to their goal.
That stating, the Indians, who displayed courage and skill using advance and rear guard skirmish lines and field fortification. The fact that these Indians were running for their very lives to avoid being killed or returned to a condition unacceptable act of war. For Horseberry and Osberry, Charles Berry followed the Indian trails. They arrived at the Lemhi Agency, finding it deserted. The whites had left for Salmon, fearing the Indians would attack.
Up north to Montana we went, where we witnessed quite an event. In Darby we stayed to see the parade, but around the town we were sent. Well, brethren, I haven't been moved like I have lately for quite a while. You all know who I am. I'm Brother Allred. I told you some stories about Grandpa Allred down to Springdale. It's one of the upriver folk rather than downriver down by Rockville and other places. I don't know if you're aware that the Allred group is there. They're brethren that have lost their way, as we say. On the high road to apostasy, they didn't follow President Woodruff and stop the practice of polygamy. They've kept it right on, and it's a little embarrassing sometimes to be an Allred. But I did notice that they have a slogan there, and it says, right outside the town limits, "We never met a teenage girl we didn't like to marry." Speaking of apostasy, I've been somewhat disturbed because some of you, brethren, have exhibited some signs of apostasy yourselves. I've noticed that there's been some behavior that's less than admirable. First, the use of profane language in the taking of the Lord's name in vain. It's rather prevalent and totally unacceptable in this group. May I suggest some substitute word? One associate of mine, when he's rather angry, will say, "Got dandruff and some of it itches." Second, some unhealthy and vulgar habits. I was admonishing Brother Bagley this morning about his use of tobacco, which he's doing right now. And he said the only thing he worried about was that it would stunt his growth. Also, hot drinks are not for the belly. You should drink it cold. I guess you know that the difference between a good Mormon and a bad Mormon is the temperature of his caffeine. Well, brethren, I could go on and on, but I really must close, and I was trying to think of some appropriate words from the scriptures, and the scripture came to mind, "Seek ye out of the best books," and I'd just like to paraphrase and say, "Seek them from me."
Thank you. took one of the iron rims off of the wagon wheel, and with just, well, I don't know what, a hammer, he got that whole thing flattened out, perfectly flat. With a cold chisel, he cut teeth into it, to that, sharpened the teeth up, hooked it to the other side of the water wheel. But he made a big crank out of other tire, of the iron wheel things. And so he made a big crank out of that, and then he hooked it to the other side, but he hooked it vertically so they could saw up and down, and now they had a way to cut planks for floors.
Big hole, there was quite a fight where the Nez Perce were caught in flight. They were caught off guard. The Army struck hard. It surely was a gruesome sight.
It was early morning of August 9th, 1877. A combined force of civilian volunteers and 7th U.S. Infantry moved down the valley, across the wooded hillside, and deployed between the bald hillside and the river below. At the second bend in the river, the Indians had set up a village of 89 teepees. They had fled from their homeland following an attempt to put them on a reservation. It had been a hard journey for the Nez Perce band of 700 men, women, and children. Now they rested. They felt safe, thinking they had escaped from a war they did not want. At dawn, Natalikin, one of the old men of the band, rode out to tend his horses that were grazing with others on the hillside. As he neared the troops, he was shot. The attack began with the troops charging through the willows, across the river, into the camp. Indians, dazed and groggy with sleep, started from their teepees only to be shot down or clubbed as they stepped outside. While the troops tried to burn the village, the warriors rallied and began a defense. The Indians scattered, found shelter, and delivered a deadly crossfire. Soon the troops were forced from the village, then back across the river to the wooded slope just up the valley. There they dug in for a siege. The warriors kept the troops pinned down for the rest of that day and the following night, until their families had buried the dead, packed their remaining possessions, and continued eastward.
Senior Jerome Stoffel. I raise a glass for a shot for the Grasshopper Society. Yeah. Henry's store.
Chief Tendoy was a peaceful man, the head of a Shoshone band. He'd forsaken war and opened the door to peace in his beautiful land. Nez Perce, Mormons, Lewis and Clark, we discussed until it got dark. On to Fort Limhi, where Mormons did try to make there a permanent mark.
At Limhi Pass, there's a stream whose beginning is like a dream. Becomes Mighty Mo with barely a flow, found by the Lewis and Clark team. Thank you. capital town, whose fortunes went up and went down. H. Plummer and gang, the people did hang, and the first best place lost its crown.
Trial. A legal trial. I'm the sheriff. You can't do this.
You brought it on yourself.
I need time to get my affairs in order.
With the execution of Plummer, Stinson, and Ray, the alleged high command of the road agents had been eliminated.
Thank you.